Get ready. We got another one coming.
I'm ready.
Can you fix it?
Well, your radiator shot. We can put some water in her, but you ain't gonna get very far. Where are you heading? Ain't you seen the things going on the TV?
Yeah, I seen. I've also seen that same old man come out those doors for the last 30 years. Ever since I was able to drive, I would deliver whiskey to that old bastard. And one thing I know, is he was never late coming out that door. Now, the way I see it, you two son of a bitch would probably have him propped up somewhere with a bullet in his head. That's doing me a favor. But at the end of the day, he's still my old man.
I see earthquakes and lightning. I see bad times today. Don't go around tonight, but it's bound to take your life. There's a bad moon on the rise.
Oh, shit.
Shay, get up.
I'm tired of running, Caleb. We've been running for days.
Yeah, and we're gonna keep running because we made a choice to leave.
No, I made a choice. You made a choice to follow. Why did you follow? You could have stayed.
Because I don't kill people for enjoyment. That's what the horsemen do. They kill for nothing.
Okay, but what are we gonna do?
I'll say we got maybe a day and a half before Ryder gets close. There's a barn about a quarter mile up this path. We can stay for the night and be on our way in the morning.
Caleb, Ryder and Cade, they won't stop, will they?
No, not as long as my chip is still active.
When the government collapses, this man shows up and creates a currency for all, a microchip. And now all the gold, silver, it's all gone, all of it.
Why do you think they kept me around? It was only a matter of time before I end up like so many before us.
Yes, but countries were rebuilding because of the chips. Economies were better, people weren't taxed, all credit card debt was erased. It was like a fresh new start. Digital cash transfers took over and people simply swiped their wrist to purchase. If the money was there, great. If not, no debt could be incurred.
Yeah, and look at us now, Shay. 3 months after the computer glitch, people lost everything. Their houses, their jobs. Look around. Rioting, looting, murder, war. These things aren't just gonna go away. People can't even get out of the cities.
Okay, Caleb, what do we do?
We need to get just beyond that barn, about a quarter mile to the old Boyer's property. There's an open field there. In 3 days' time, my brother will be there to pick us up in a helicopter.
Is your brother even still in the military?
Yeah, Shay, he is. He's only stationed a few days from here. He'll be there. He's never let me down before. We're gonna get out of here.
Not if Ryder gets to us first.
What you doing here, girl? Don't you know this is Horseman country?
Please just take my stuff and leave.
Don't you worry, I will. But first I want a taste. Better have something to eat in here. What the? You're sick!
Did you ever stop to ask yourself who's the hunter and who's the hunted?
You are one sick.
Hunted.
Why do you have to kill every single one? Why can't we just take their stuff and leave them?
Because we're collectors, Ellie. We collect.
Nobody collects this sick crap.
You want to leave? Then leave! And otherwise, shut your mouth!
I just want to eat.
There's a barn 3 miles over the ridge. There's traffic there. That's where we eat. Grab my gear and let's go.
Got your head in the bag.
How much farther?
There it is.
Can I help you?
Hello, this is Caleb and I'm Shay. We're looking for a place to hold up for the night.
We don't have much, but the little that we do have, it's yours.
That won't be necessary. There's plenty to go around.
Is it just you here? You need to know there's more people coming this way.
People are still trying to escape the cities.
Oh, I've got people that check in on me from time to time. In fact, one of them should have been here over an hour ago. You should know the Horsemen of the Apocalypse. They're the ones that run these parts. And they've been cutting people down since the collapse. Which makes me wonder how you two slipped through the cracks. Sounds like my guest has arrived.
Really matter?
Caleb, now, they're coming. Caleb, we have to tell them.
I know.
No need. No. We already know.
Caleb.
Hey. I'll take that. You heard what they said, Roach. The Horsemen are coming.
Yeah, and these two escaped somehow. I wonder if they serve any importance.
You know, you can't negotiate with the Horsemen, Roach.
Negotiate? I don't plan on negotiating. I want them all together. Same place, same time.
You want a what? And how the hell are we gonna do that?
Help from a man that fears no man. Victor.
Victor? Victor listens to no one except Victor!
Yes, but we have a common interest. Victor wants complete power, and so do I. If Victor and the Horsemen kill each other, that leaves me to govern. And this whole area will be mine. I control trade, I control food and water supply, and we can especially catch all those scabs that have chips. Everything will go through me.
If Victor finds out, he will kill us both. Don't contact Victor. Don't. Don't be a fool.
I already have.
Oh,
brought the pansy.
Listen, Victor.
Who says I'm talking about you?
You know what? Never mind.
Who am I kidding? Of course I'm talking about you.
Lay off, Parker. He's in it like the rest of us.
So why are we picking up this girl, Rev? She's just gonna be dead weight and slow us down.
She goes everywhere I go. No exceptions. I made a promise to her father.
You know, we were doing just fine on our own.
Oh, yeah, yeah. You were doing just great. If it weren't for me, we'd all still be stuck in Fort Scott.
I would still rather be in Fort Scott.
Hey, keep talking, pansy boy. They would have loved you passing you around like a cheap play toy.
You shut your mouth, Victor.
Enough! Victor, pull the car over. Victor, right now, this is all we have, is one another.
The game has changed, Reverend. It's a dog-eat-dog world now, and only the strong survive.
There's only one dog in here, Victor, and he needs to be put down.
I'm gonna put you down, boy!
No, Victor, not today, not ever.
Where are we going, Reverend?
I know a place just east of here. It's in Johnson County. Could be there before nightfall.
Johnson County? The horsemen run Johnson County. We don't want to run into any horsemen.
And they're probably thinking the same thing about Victor and the Reverend. But this guy Roach, now he's a real douchebag. And this invitation, it's not without warrant.
What do you think his motive is?
I don't know. But if I don't like it, I'm going to bury him.
There's someone out there.
Pansy boy seeing things again?
I told you someone was out there.
Everyone stay in the car.
You son of a bitch! Ah!
Is this who you are now?
Get back!
Is this how it's gonna go
down? I said get back!
Us at each other's throats?
I said get back!
Look at you. Put the gun down, Victor.
Reverend, I told you. It was a dog-eat-dog world! And a dog's gotta eat.
Can someone tell me why Bob is decorating this tree? Cade, can you please tell everyone why Bob is not with us today?
Because somebody didn't do their job. Everybody's assigned to someone, so nobody's left alone.
So the question is, which one of you was assigned to Bob? See, I'd ask over Robert here, and although it'd probably be the most intelligent conversation we've ever had, I don't think I'll get anything out of him.
Whoa! Well, so glad y'all can join us. We were just talking about poor Bobby here.
What about you, Piper? Was you assigned to Bob?
No.
Well, what about any of you?
No.
Wasn't me.
Or me.
Well?
Well, what?
Are you just gonna stand there, or are you gonna tell us why you're not laying dead next to poor Bob over there?
It wasn't me, it was Cade.
He's lying! Ryder! He's lying!
Shut
I'm
up,
telling
Cade.
You!
Now, Blaine, please, continue.
He's always wanted control, Ryder. Any chance that he's got of killing you, he's gonna take it. Look what happened to poor Bob over there. Got in the way of his plans.
Now, Blaine, that's one hell of a story. Nah.
He said it wasn't him, man.
Hey, Ryder, how did you know it wasn't me?
Because it was me! I exiled Bob 2 days ago. And Blaine here, well, he's just a coward.
That's some crazy stuff, man.
We're all a little crazy. And Blaine, so quick to blame others in his own group. Think what he would have done if he were captured by outsiders. That's why we rule this whole county. We dispose of the weak, and we keep the strong. Now, can somebody please tell me why I have two dead horsemen in the garage, one in the middle of the road, and these two, well, we won't count these two.
Ryder, the guy that killed Earl and Dale, radio traffic said he was associated with Roach.
There's probably a good chance that Caleb and Shay are there too.
Roach's place is 3 miles over the ridge.
Yeah, not too far. Think Roach's time is running out. Cade, get all the horsemen together. We take Roach's place by nightfall.
This is beautiful, Reverend. Can we stay, please?
Tessa, we gotta make sure it's safe first. Looks abandoned.
Trust me, that sleazebag Roach is around here somewhere.
And this piece of meat, Reverend, that you wanted to pick up, she's gonna get one of us killed.
Better show some respect when you walk through them doors.
You know what? You're right.
I see Victor's arrived.
Roach! Down here!
Roach and Boone, two turds clogging the toilet.
Real funny, Victor. Real funny.
Listen, Victor, we got big problems.
Hey, you have to let us out of here!
This is the problem I'm talking about.
Why do you have them caged like animals?
They're horsemen, you idiots!
Look, we took this mark after the collapse. We don't kill innocent people, and that's why we left.
Well, that's great, but you know we can't let you out.
Listen, the horsemen, they're coming. And they're gonna kill every single person in this place unless we get out of here.
It involves killing horsemen. We're in. Whoa! We're here to kill horsemen, just like you.
And eat. Do you have any food?
Reverend, we don't know him. He looks like another Victor to me.
At ease, pansy boy. Anybody up for killing horsemen's okay with me.
I've got plenty of food upstairs next to the generator.
Hey, before those horsemen get here, we need to cut off those lights in that generator.
Hey! Let us out so we can help!
I think we should start with killing these two.
No one's killing anyone. I'm sorry.
We have a helicopter.
Shay, no!
It's coming tomorrow, not far from here, but you have to let us out of here first, or no deal.
I think they're lying. We should kill them.
Why should we believe two scabs like you anyway?
Listen, my brother is in the military. He was stationed a few days from here in Fort Scott. He gave me a time.
We just left Fort Scott 3 days ago. It wasn't pretty. Who's your brother?
John. John Sorensen.
I knew him. He was solid.
Yeah, I knew John. He was an asshole.
Go ahead, let him out.
Enough of the introductions. We have less than an hour before nightfall. And we don't have any weapons.
I got special plans for you later.
Oh, we've got plenty of weapons.
Looks like they're grabbing supplies. Maybe for an assault later. Ryder, Caleb's with them.
Yeah, I kind of figured that. We're gonna have to get to him before Roach realizes his chip's active.
Ryder, you think he knows yet?
No. If he knew, he would have already tried to move him. Ryder, you think we should move in now? No, Cade. I already told you. We'll take him tonight while he's asleep.
Listen up. We're gonna put two on top, two downstairs. The rest of you get some rest. We'll come back and we'll rotate every few hours.
It's gonna be a long night.
Reverend? Did my father ever say anything before? Well, you know.
Just know your father loved you, and I did promise him I'd take care of you. Plus, we can't let anyone know that that chip is still active. In the wrong hands of someone like the Horseman, it can mean the worst. Do you think your brother's gonna show?
Yeah, I do. Listen, Reverend, I know you don't know me, but Ryder and the Horseman, they're not gonna just let us walk out of here. A lot of people are gonna die tonight.
You don't think there's a chance they might actually pass by tonight, do you?
No, not while I have this. I didn't tell you earlier, but you just can't trust anyone anymore.
Damn, another chip? You just make sure you get us to that chopper tomorrow.
Get everyone up now.
I don't think so. You wake everybody up and you ruin our element of surprise.
If I don't wake these people up, they're not gonna get a fighting chance. The Reverend would agree.
I don't care about your people. Look, you Horseman reject, you need to learn that we have no place here.
Everyone has a place. I need everyone to get up, quickly, quickly, get up, get up, get up. I need everyone to arm yourselves if you can. Find a place to hide. Whatever you do, don't go outside the barn, no matter what. Where's the Reverend?
He went after the girl, Tessa.
I need help to find her. Listen, you need, if I don't make it back, I need you to get everyone in a helicopter.
Okay, but I don't think that's a good
idea. Shay, it's important. I need you to do this.
Okay.
I need you to protect these people. Whatever it takes.
Of course.
If we get a chance, we need to kill Victor and Ryder. That girl Tessa, she's got an active chip. Make sure nothing happens to her until I get it out of her.
You better start paying me, Roach.
See her. No, Reverend.
If he's out there, he'll find her.
you now!
Let me go!
Did your daddy teach you that? Well, get her up.
Barn, you have something I want. Some of you have fertilized land with my men tonight, but I'm willing to let that go. All is forgiven. Just hand over Caleb and we'll walk away. If not, I promise you, none of you will live to see tomorrow afternoon.
I'm getting out of here.
Damn right you are.
Let's just kill him now.
Figure this sack of meat to be good for something.
Shay, you know where that helicopter will be tomorrow. Make sure everyone gets out there.
Caleb, I'm not—
No one's going anywhere. I got a better idea.
Hit.
Look, Rev, there's no way you can get out here alive.
My eye! Let me out! Please don't me!
Please don't me!
We got Caleb! We're bringing him out! Bring him forward.
Look at him, Ryder.
Like fish in a barrel.
Oh Lord, heaven's waiting, open up your door. Oh Lord, heaven's waiting, open up your door. Lead me home, lead me home. Lead me home, lead me home. Lead me home.
This is the best decision you could have made. Why does he keep moving?
Caleb didn't want to come, so we had to shut his mouth.
I'm pretty sure Caleb knows what I think of traitors. May I? Why, thank you. I don't remember him being so weak.
Are we done here?
Of course. You are all free to go. Piper, will you show Caleb what we do to traitors?
I never liked you anyway.
Bring me his chip.
Keep walking.
Let's go.
Not here, Bob.
What do you mean it's not there?
I mean it's not here.
Get out of my way. Kill them all! No!
I'm not going to fight you,
and you're not just gonna shoot me.
You can't fight me.
You're right, I can't, but he can.
I'm going to help.
No. If Victor survives, I need you to kill him and that other animal too.
What about the helicopter?
I don't care about the helicopter. We're going to run this entire county. Everyone from cities is going to come here, and I will build an army. And this place will be known as...
Boone and Roach's one stop from hell?
No. Don't be stupid. Purgatory.
I don't think Victor will care much for your plans, Roach.
Kill him.
Since he's sneaky.
I got him! Go and kill him!
Go ahead and drop that pistol. Slowly. Step away. You didn't really think I was running, did you?
Guys like you don't run.
I don't run because I don't like to. I don't like to because it makes me tired.
You be a man.
Take off that blouse. I won't need this.
That's not gonna be enough.
You know your friend? The big one?
We're not that different, him and I.
Ain't no one like you. Ain't nobody like you. Don't do it.
Kill me! Oh, get him up!
Let him go, Ratchet!
You hold your tongue!
I don't want to be part of this.
You come back! I'll find you!
Ratchet, shut up and kill him already!
Let him go! What is this, Victor?
Well, you see, Devlin, your friend here, he wanted to kill you.
Dog-eat-dog world, Reverend. You need to remember that.
Now, take these two down and let them bleed out in the holding cell. And you. I don't trust you. I don't like you. And the only reason I'm letting you live is because you're going to run this place. And in turn, I'm going to let you live.
Of course, Victor. Anything you want.
Now, can you please find me the girl Shay, who knows where my helicopter is!
They gotta be abandoned. Reverend, we don't have a lot of time. The helicopter's gonna be here in less than an hour, and we still have to cross over several acres. Caleb! You okay? Come on, Rev, we've gotta get out of here! Caleb, a bandage. Caleb, I don't think your brother's gonna make it.
You know, you're lucky to be alive. Someone's watching over you.
Hello, is anyone listening here? We're 7 minutes past the deadline.
Seven? That's what I call you, Lucky Seven.
Get down!